Welcome to episode of the Naked Thai Chef Cooking. Just kidding. Today, we're going to make some delicious pork chops. And the ingredients we're going to use is, of course, a rum, Bacardi rum, a sesame, soy sauce, oyster sauce, salt and pepper, butter, thyme, and cilantro, because my friend Aaron hates cilantro, so I'm gonna put a lot. And a little limon. Voila! So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just coat these with salt and pepper, nothing too fancy, etc. Maybe I'll put a little some rum on there. All right, here we go. Oh, and I forgot garlic, of course garlic. So we're just gonna salt and pepper it. I'm using some nice, I don't like the iodine salt. I like the thicker pieces of salt because they are less salty for some odd reason. So doing some sea salt. Rub it in there, rub it in there. And you don't want any soy sauce now because then it'll taste, there's a trick to it because it'll taste like, what do you call it, liver, when you put soy sauce ahead of time. So just douse it with pepper and salt. That's all you need to do for now until you cook it with the butter. Voila. Next thing I do is I take the cilantro and I cut the stem. That's what I kind of want to cook in the butter. So every cilantro is used because the top garnish is for garnish. You can do that at the end a little bit if you want, but the bottom is really the cooking one. So it's not going to need that. And you're going to have a couple of thymes. And I'm going to rinse these out. Thyme's delicious. Okay, I'm just gonna crack some garlic. Easy way to crush garlic. Just a side of the thing. If you don't have a garlic crusher, like I do you at home, and it's all ready to go. So what we're gonna do is start on the cooking. Alright, turn down the oven. And we can put the butter first. I'm gonna let that melt away. Once it's a little melted, then we're gonna put the garlic in there. Okay, batter's there. Let's put some of this garlic in there. See, the idea is I have smell addiction. The smell of that cooking garlic is delicious. I kind of want the butter on high heat, so then you're going to put cilantro and thyme in there. Maybe not so much cilantro, and I'll kill it in. Now, pork on there. If you had a grill afterwards, you could grill it to give that little grill flavor. We don't have a grill, so we're gonna stick with what we got. Baste it all. Steak is, you know when it's done, if you don't have a thermometer, is you poke it. If it stays down, that means not ready, it should like be bouncy up. If it doesn't bounce at all, that means it's overcooked. At the bottom, give it like brown, and then I'll change it. The cheat is always to cut and see if it's ready or not. As you see, it's brown, right? So that brown, and then you kind of poke it, see how much it bounces back. Okay, it might be some, that's okay. It's actually but good. So when it's almost done, is when you put all the sauces in there. So you're gonna put your soy sauce. Oyster sauce. Rum to caramelize it a little more. Don't worry, the rum burns off.
beautiful.
Okay. And really, once it's done, that's when you put the sesame oil in there, because sesame oil kind of burns out. So sesame always just lasts, so it doesn't have that weird burnt taste to it. And it's ready. So, and I, like I said, if you had a grill, I would take it out in the grill, grill it up. So that looks so beautiful. And then the sauce here, you can actually, what I'm gonna do is gonna make a caramelized onions as well as green beans, which I'll show you next. So that is pork chops, buttered pork chops.